अगर आप चाहते हैं कि आपको न्यू वीडियोस के बारे में तल्ला मिले तो आप चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें। मोबाइल यूजर्स सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल बटन दबाएं।
السلام عليكم. My name is Gaith. I'm from Iraq. PhD student in computer science from UUM. I would like to ask you about computer science was built depend on the simulation between human functions and at the same time artificial intelligence as a field from computer science already defined depend on the simulation of function of human beings. So my question, did you find verses from the Holy Quran define the relationship between information technology or computer science and the human beings?
That was the question, that did I find anything in the Quran between computer science and human beings? If you noted, in the beginning of my talk, I said, Quran is not a book of science, science. It's a book of signs, science. There's a lot of information that's in the Quran. If you ask me, does the Quran say 2 plus 2 is equal to 4? I don't know any verse in the Quran which says 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. That does not mean 2 plus 2 is not equal to 4. So everything of science is not there in the Quran, but whatever Quran has said, there is not a single verse of the Quran which goes against established science. So Quran is not a book of science, but everything what is mentioned about science is 100% perfect. You're asking about computer science, there are, and if I have to link it with computer, I do believe that though computer science says that trying to get an artificial intelligence, but Allah's creation of the human being is far superior than the computer. And there have been many a times competition between human beings and the computer. And if you have heard of the famous mathematician from India, Shakuntala Devi, she had a competition with the fastest computer and they gave an equation which was very long and she defeated the computer with, I think, 10 or 20 seconds. So the human being, what Allah has made the God-given computer, is far superior than a normal computer. But when you're talking about maths, let me link it, the closest we can think about, you know, a computer and intelligence, that can you think that the Quran is computer coded, for example. The basis of mathematics was first propounded by Aristotle, who said that every statement can either be true or false. So the base, the foundation of mathematics is on the statement of Aristotle, every statement can be true or false. So one person came and asked the question, what if this statement is false? Every statement can be true or false. What if this statement is false? Whole mathematics collapsed. Then they came up with a rule that whenever you say something, it either meaning-wise or mentioning-wise. Meaning-wise or mentioning-wise. You say something either meaning-wise or mentioning-wise. Just to give you a small example, that does the Quran contain any contradictions? Who says that Quran doesn't contain contradictions? Raise your hand. Who says Quran doesn't contain contradiction? Any ikhtilaf, raise your hand. Who says Quran doesn't contain contradictions? Raise your hand. Quran doesn't contain ikhtilaf, raise your hand. So most of you all think that Quran contains contradiction. Who says Quran contains contradiction? Raise your hand. I know that's easier to ask. I always ask the opposite so that people who are tired, they get up. Who says Quran contains contradiction? Raise your hand. No one. Who says Quran contains ikhtilaf? Raise your hand. No one. I am raising my hand. I am telling that Quran contains contradiction. You say, what? Dr. Zakir Naik gave a lecture for about an hour and now he says Quran contains contradiction? Yes, Quran contains. Quran contains ikhtilaf. Open the Quran. Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 82 says, Afala is the Buran Quran. Walau kana min indi gairila lavajadu fiktilafan kasira. Do not the unbelievers, do you not ponder the Quran with care? Had it been from anyone besides Allah, there would have been many contradictions. The word contradiction is there in the Quran. So all of you are wrong, I am right. Does the Quran contain contradiction, yes or no? Mentioning wise, yes. Meaning wise, no. Mentioning wise? The Quran says, Afala yadabbarun al Quran. Walau kana min indi ghairilla lawajadu fiktilafan kaseera. Do they not consider the Quran with care? Had it been from anyone besides Allah, there would have been contradictions. Many contradictions. So now, meaning wise, we know there is no contradiction, not a single. But mentioning wise, there is. That means meaning wise the Quran is right, mentioning wise the Quran is no. Even mentioning wise Quran is not wrong. Why? It says iktilafan kaseera, many contradictions. You read the full Quran, the word contradiction is only once. The Quran says, had the Quran been from anyone besides Allah, there would have been many contradictions, iktilafan kaseera. So even mentioning wise the Quran is not wrong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken care that mentioning wise there is only one. So meaning wise there is no contradiction, we know that. But if someone wants to attack the Quran and prove it wrong, mentioning wise also they cannot do it. Let me give you one more example. Quran says in Surah Maidah chapter 5 verse 100. That all those who reject our signs are like dogs. All those who reject our signs are like dogs. That means all those who reject the signs of Almighty God, they are like dogs. Is there any problem in that? Meaning wise, no problem. Mentioning wise, if you count in the Quran, all those who reject our signs is mentioned 5 times and kalb, dog, is also mentioned 5 times. So meaning wise, it is correct. All those reject our signs are like dogs. Even mentioning wise, 5 times, all those reject our signs, dogs is also 5 times. If you see, if you read, Quran says in Surah Imran, chapter 3, verse 49, Inna masala Isa inda laika misal Adam, khalaqa min turab, summa qala lakun fayakun. The similitude of Jesus in front of Adam is the same. The similitude of Jesus in front of Allah is the same like Adam, peace be upon him. Allah said, kun fayakun, be and it was. So we know the example that when people say, you know, that Jesus is Almighty God because he had no father. So Allah says, Adam, peace be upon him, had no mother and no father. The example of Jesus, peace be upon him, is like Adam. Allah said, kun fayakun. So meaning wise, we know that Isa alayhi salam was created by miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Adam alayhi salam was created from miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when it says, Inna masala Isa indallahi ka masala Adam, the similitude of Adam and Jesus is the same. If you count Isa alayhi salam in the Quran, whole Quran, it is mentioned 25 times. If you count Adam alayhi salam in the whole Quran, even that is mentioned 25 times. So meaning wise it is correct, mentioning wise it is correct. Quran says that zulumat is not like noor, darkness is not like light. Meaning wise it is correct. If you count zulumat, I think it is about 13 times and noor is about 12 times. So meaning wise, it is not same, even counting wise it is not same. Now you are talking about mathematical code. Not only when the Quran says in Surah Imran chapter 3 verse 49, Inna masal Isa inda laika misal Adam. The 25 times Isa alayhi salam, 25 times Adam alayhi salam. If you count from Surah Fatiha till Surah Imran chapter 3 verse 49, Isa alayhi salam is mentioned the 7th time. Even Adam alayhi salam is mentioned 7th time. So if you have to jumble and put maybe Surah Fatiha in the middle and maybe Surah Nas in the starting, this code would be disrupted. So today if we analyze the Quran with computer, it is impossible for a human being to write a book which is meaning wise correct and mentioning wise also correct, with so many different messages. So this word, the glorious Quran, this book, the glorious Quran, cannot be from a human being, has to be from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you put the Quran to the test of computer, even a computer to create this would be impossible. So this is the closest I can think that if you want to analyze the Quran through a computer. So anything, if you read, there are many examples, you can give a lecture only on the mathematical code that the Quran has. Yes, brother.
I found one verse from the Holy Quran talking about the simulation. The ayah in Surah An-Nahl. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تَتَفَكَّرُونَ. That means we should thinking about ourselves or themselves functions. So I think this verse push us to thinking about the simulation, how we can make the simulation between the human being functions, and how we can use these functions to help the humans.
Yes, thinking about the similarity, there are many verses. Quran says, Afala yuminun, will you not then believe? The Quran is meant for those men of understanding. So like that, there are many verses which tell you to ponder upon the human, and the Quran says, this book is for the men of understanding. So Quran, the beauty of the Quran is that one verse, it has a variety of meaning. It can satisfy an intellectual, a scientist, and even can satisfy a layman who's uneducated. The beauty of the Quran is that the same verse can satisfy a variety of people. The same verse, it is the best Arabic literature. The same verse is a miracle. The same verse is science. Tomorrow there may be another age of I don't know what. So Quran, the beauty of the Quran is it proves itself to be the word of God in all the ages. That is the beauty of the Quran. That today is not the age of literature and poetry. Yet, it is the best Arabic literature. At the same time, it is scientific. Tomorrow, maybe after 100 years, the science will not carry much weight. Like today, poetry doesn't carry much weight. So whichever age comes, the beauty of the Quran is it will prove itself to be the word of God in all the ages.
अगर आप चाहते हैं कि आपको न्यू वीडियोस के बारे में तल्ला मिले तो आप चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें मोबाइल यूजर्स सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल बटन दबाएं।